A number of 3D printers have been purchased on banggood.com, and for those of you who have used my links, thank you very much, I appreciate it. When I started using the 3D printer, I knew absolutely nothing about it, and I had the advantage of having a friend who was able to share a number of settings, especially on Cura, to help me get started, and that's what I intend to do here. This is the first time I've done a video like this, so we'll see how it goes. I'm using Cura 2.6.1, which is nowhere near the latest version. I'm using this version because my friend was using this version, and I just have not gotten around to changing or updating. So if it's not broke, don't fix it. And this is working fine for me so far. When you load this program, you're going to have to name your printer in there somewhere, and I assume you're naming it the CR10 or whatever printer you bought. And so in my case, it's a CR10. And when we go to Preferences, Configure Cura, and come down here to Printers, Machine Settings, make this a little bigger. This is the size of your bed. The bed is rectangular. It's heated. We're using Rip Wrap Marlin Sprinter. And you want to have these codes in the start G code, and you want to have this in the end G code. You have one extruder, and this is your material and nozzle size. And that's all there is to that. Over here in printer setup, you'll have a whole bunch of settings that you can go through. And then we'll just scroll down here real slow. My layer height is 0.1. I do that on almost all of my prints. I'd rather have a quality print than a fast print. Wall thickness, top and bottom thicknesses, layers. Infill density, this will vary with whatever it is you're printing. If you click on recommend, there's a bunch of pre-selected densities here. You can click this box as to whether you want support or not, or what type of build plate adhesion. We'll go to that in a minute. I'm printing on a smooth plastic plate. Personally, I'm running 210 degrees on the hot end and 60 degrees on the build plate. You can play with these temperatures to see what works best for your material. There is some variance between the different PLA. And some colors will print a bit differently. Printer speed, the faster you run the head back and forth, the quicker you'll get the print done. And on the other side of the coin, you'll possibly have a lower quality. I have settled on a print speed of 35 and a travel speed of 60. Because I'm on that plastic plate, my initial layer speed is 17.5 and travel is 30. And my fan does not come on until after the first layer. I have turned on combing. Combing makes your print head move around a bit more, but in the end, your print will be quicker. Occasionally, depending on the complexity of the parts, or if I'm printing more than one part at a time, I may use this void parts when traveling in Z-Hop. That's something you can play with. Initial fan speed is 0. That comes on after the first layer has been built. And build plate adhesion, I use a skirt usually, and all that does is make a track around the part be printed a couple of times, and this helps to make sure that the material is flowing out the nozzle before it starts printing the part. If you have a problem with parts sticking to the build plate, you may use a raft. I haven't really found a use for brim. As you go up and down through here, you'll find one of these little wheels. If you click on the wheel, it'll take you to the settings. If a setting is checked here, it will show up over here on the side of Cura. So you can see that I have layer height, initial layer height, line width, and those are all showing up here. If you hover over one of these items, a little block will pop up and it'll explain what that pertains to. It can be quite helpful determining what you want to try. Collapse these settings or expand them again. One other thing, come back here to machine settings. I believe it's these numbers right here that you want to make sure are in here. And what that does is when you start a print and your head goes to the home position, it will then extrude 30 millimeters of material to make sure that your hot end and nozzle are loaded and flowing freely. Go to File, open the file, and pick whatever STL file you want to put into Cura for slicing. In this case, it's a little boat called Benchy. And this is a pretty good test for determining how your printer is printing. If you use your wheel on your mouse, you can zoom in on that. If you push that wheel down, you can raise this up higher. Use the left arrow key and the right arrow key. You can turn it one way or the other. This is the down arrow key. You can look underneath, and if something is all red like this, then it is touching the build plate, and that will become more important later on. And then you can go up and you can look down on top of this, and you can still turn it one way or the other to get a better view. If you click on this item and you go up here, you're at 0, 0 in your X and Y settings. That means this will start dead zero on your build plate. If you drag this thing around, you're no longer in the zero position in X. You can make that zero again by typing in 0, and it'll jump back here again. Click on this again. If you want to resize this, you can have uniform scaling, and you can make this boat bigger by 50%, or you can make it smaller. And with uniform scaling, these all change at the same time. We'll return that to 100. Click on this again. This item allows you to rotate this thing. A lot of times from Thingiverse, you'll find one of these things and it's sitting upside down or something. So you want to click on these. The red one rotates about the X axis. And snap rotation, if you lay flat, that will put it back on the build plate. No, it didn't. And we want to look and see if we are down on the build plate. Yes, we are attached to the build plate again because this is all red on the bottom. And check our position. We have moved around so we can put that back to 0 and 0. After you scan this, if you have all your settings correct, you come down here in the lower right corner and you say prepare. And this thing will start slicing this model. And right down here at the bottom, it'll tell you that it's going to take about 3 hours and 43 minutes. The estimated time on these tends to be a bit slow. This will probably take 4 hours to print. And then you can save this to file, and you can create a file here, which is your G-code. And this is what you take to the printer. If you have used support, it doesn't usually show up here, unless you go down here and you say layers. And then you can look, you can suck this thing down all the way down to ground zero. That is the first layer. It's going to put a skirt around the object. And as you come up, this will actually, and this is your layer count. When you get to layer 22, you're at this point. You come up, you're starting to build a deck right about here. That would be layer 82. And if you take 82 and multiply it by 0.1, that's how high this will be at this point in time. It takes a long time to put one of these down. And right on up to the top. And when you get all the way up to the top, it has printed 478 layers, 0.1 millimeter high. Back here, you go back to solid. And that's about all I can tell you about that. Now, we can zoom back out on this. And you can right click here and you can say clear build plate. And that gets rid of everything. Whatever settings you have over here, when you close Cura, when you open it again, these settings will still be there. So if you're printing something different the next time, you need to pay attention to what's going on over here. This is Benchy printed at 100% original size. This is available with each of these different parts as a separate file, so you can print them in different colors and then assemble this. I haven't done that yet, but that would be an interesting project. Look at a few other things. This is a top that takes 3/8 inch nuts to use as weights to help maintain its spinning. This thing has a problem with the file size. I have not found anywhere in Cura where you can change from millimeters to inches. And one thing you have to watch, when you draw something in Fusion 360 in inches, if you import that into Cura, it will be a dot down here that you can't even see. You have to go back to Fusion 360 and change the dimensions to millimeters and resave the STL file. Then when you bring it back into Cura, it will be the proper size. This thing has sized itself at some ridiculous number, but it's wrong. And I could not find a way to reasonably measure on these squares what this thing, what size it was. It tells me here that it's 225 millimeters, which is about 10 inches in diameter, which is way too big. This thing is actually about 2 1/4 inches in diameter. We do know flap to flap for a 3/8 bolt, that's going to be about 9/16, I believe. In any case, I will show you some pictures of what I did to zero in on the size for the spinner. And sometimes you have to do this. Do a test print to see if it's printing for you correctly, or if you need to change something. The first size I did on this was 2800% size. This thing resized itself to 10,000%. To come up with this 10-inch diameter spinner. I started off 2800, and that reduced it down pretty close. And I did a print, and that was still too big. And I did another print at 2650 and at 2600. Finally, when I got down to 2550, it was the correct size. And the nuts would go into these pockets very nicely. And again, it's always a good idea to flip this thing over and look at the bottom and make sure that it is contacting the build plate. One other little trick that I learned about Cura that probably haven't run across. I read a casual mention about anything that is below the build plate will not be printed. So if I click on this and I go to move, and on the Z axis, if I make that minus 50, too far. Minus 10 millimeters. If I look at that, I swing that up, this is 10 millimeters below the build plate. That will not be printed if I don't change this. Only this portion that is above the build plate will be printed. I'll move that back to zero. You can look back down here and I am contacting the build plate again. If I look here, it looks like it's not touching the build plate, but that's actually a fillet radius. So with that information, I think you can go out and start melting some plastic and having fun. If you have a simple question, ask me. I am not a computer expert, and I do not pretend to be one. That's actually a 5/16 bolt, and it's 9/16 across the flats. The first one of these I did was 2800 size, and that nut was very loose in there. The next one was 2650%. And the nut was still loose in there. Then I did 2600, and we're getting closer, but it was still a bit loose. And the final one, this was printed at 2550, and those nuts are in there quite firm. Then on the bottom of this, I used a quarter inch bearing. I found that hole to be a little bit tight, and I used different reamers in sequence to just sneak up on a perfect quarter inch size, and I deepened it just a little bit so that that bearing was below this surface past the center line of the bearing, and I used epoxy to come over the edge of that. That will never come out of there. This has a little wobble to it. I don't have a scale accurate enough to bring each of these nuts into perfect balance with each other. But even with this wobble, this will spin for over 2 minutes. Perfectly balanced, this thing will go for 3, maybe 4 minutes. This is one of the items on Thingiverse that works very well.